Hello everyone, this is Akang Suman here. Now we will do questions based on the epicyclic gear train. In the question it is given that for the epicyclic gear arrangement shown in figure below, the gear B is fixed. What is given in the question? The gear B is fixed and the arm A, there is the arm A rotate 500 rpm in counterclockwise or you can say anticlockwise direction. The number of teeth for gear B, C and D are given. So I'm just writing here number of teeth on the gear B, that is 20. Okay, number of teeth for gear C, that is 40. And number of teeth for the gear D, that is 100. Now this is the basically side view of the gear train. If you want to see the exact front view for the diagram, let me show you. This is basically a gear. This is a gear D. Okay, this is gear D, and here it is given in the question that gear B is fixed. Okay, so here it is a gear B which is fixed. Okay, and there is another gear C which is between B and D. So that is B, gear B, this is gear C and this is gear D. And there is a arm is connected like that. Okay. So basically this is the diagram of, this is the front view of that diagram. Now see here in the diagram, there is a B and C both are mating gears and C and D are both are mating gears. But the thing is that D is basically the internal gears, means whatever be the direction of rotation for gear C, it would be the direction of rotation for the gear D. Okay, because if you see the B and C, if B is in rotation with the clockwise direction, C would be in anticlockwise direction. But D is here between C and D, it is not like that, because B and C both are connected internally. So whatever be the direction of the C, the direction of the D will be same. Okay, so now how can we solve the epicyclic gear train problems? First we need to draw the table. Okay, in every question you must have to draw the table. So in the first block I'm writing motions, and there is another arm, and then B, and then C, and then finally D. We need to find out the speed, angular speed of the gear team. Okay, given in the question that you have to find out and D, that is in rpm. So motions, in the motions block what we can write? First we have to assume that arm is fixed. I'm assuming that arm is fixed. In the first case I'm assuming that arm is fixed, and B is having x rpm in clockwise direction. I'm considering clockwise as positive directions and anticlockwise as negative directions. So it is B is having plus x rpm. Plus means clockwise direction. Plus x rpm. But it is when the arm is fixed. Okay. The condition is that arm is fixed. So here if arm is fixed, it is having zero value and B is having plus x. Okay. Since B is having T, number of teeth, that is TB, and C is having number of teeth TC, and don't write it here. We have mentioned it here. Don't write to repeat again. So that is C. If I'm talking about C, what would be the speed of the C? B, if B is in clockwise direction, C would be in anticlockwise direction. Okay, minus X multiply TB upon TC. How we have calculated this? See here, if you see the velocity ratio for B and C, that is NC upon NB. We all know that it would be TB upon TC because it is inversely proportional to the number of teeth. So from here you can calculate the magnitude, that is NC is equal to TB upon TC multiply NB. And we have assumed that the NB having the X RPM in clockwise direction, but minus 10 I'm considering because B and C both are mating gears. So if B is in clockwise direction, C would be in anticlockwise direction. So that's why I'm considering it minus sign. And if it is minus sign, that means if it is in anticlockwise direction, D would be in also anticlockwise direction. Okay, because both are internally connected. So that is minus X TB upon TC. That would be the speed of the speed of C multiply TC upon TD. Now this become the speed of the D. Okay, so here that would be cancel out. Now in the next block, we have assumed that we generally assume that arm is free. Okay, in the first block we have to assume that arm is fixed, and assuming this, we have to draw the complete complete table. In the next case, we have to assume we have to write down here that arm is free now, because this is a practical question. This is our question, that arm is free. Arm is free means arm is having 500 rpm into counterclockwise direction, that means anticlockwise direction. So if it is having 500 rpm, so that means I'm assuming that it is y rpm in clockwise direction. First I told you that just draw the table according to the gear train and then put the value in the whatever be the data you have or you have to calculate it. Okay, but first thing, you just have to draw the table. Okay, in every questions we will draw the table as same. Okay, there is nothing different to draw the table. Just if there is a structure that is a gear train which is changed according to the gear train, we will draw the table. Okay, but the procedure will be same. So that is y and that is x plus y, and that is y minus x . Having completed your table, you just have to put the values that is given in the question, and finally we'll get the answer. So that is y minus x TB upon TD. Okay, now this is the actual velocity of gear D, this is actual velocity of the gear C, and this is actual velocity of the gear B, because in the question it is given that arm is free. Okay, so y value is given in the question, arm value is given in the question, that is y is equal to 500 in counterclockwise. So I can write here minus 500, because we are assuming that clockwise direction as positive direction and anticlockwise as negative. So if y is if y is minus 500, and we all know that one thing which is given, that gear B is fixed, that means NB is equal to fix. If NB is equal to fix, that is NB is equal to 0, that means x plus y is equal to 0, and that means you'll get the value of x, that would be 500. 500 means 500 rpm in clockwise direction. Okay, we have seen here. Now if in the question it is being asked that find out the velocity of the angular speed of the gear C, so you can just put the value of x and y in that equations along with the teeth on the gear B and C. You can calculate the angular speed of the gear C, but in the question it is not asking, it is asking that the angular speed of the gear D we have to calculate. So we will put the values in these equations in the speed of the gear D, that is equal to y minus x TB upon TD. Y value is given, that is minus 500. And what is x? Minus 500 multiply TB is given, that is 20, and TD is given, that is 100. Okay, so that would be minus 600 rpm. Minus sign represent here anti-clockwise direction. So I can write here angular speed of the gear D would be 600 rpm anti-clockwise. Okay, this is anti-clockwise. So that would be the final answer. That means option B would be the correct answer. Anti-clockwise or counter-clockwise is same. Okay, so first you need to understand how to draw the table, and here you can see that I just have to put the values that is given in the question. Nothing special I have done this. Just important thing, you have to draw the table in accurate way. Okay, If you make the mistake in drawing the table, you will get the wrong answer. So the important thing, how to draw the table, you have to practice a lot of questions on the epicyclic gear trains. Otherwise, if you make a direction mistake, you will get the both the options. Here you can see clockwise and as well as anti-clockwise. So be careful about the direction as well as the magnitude. Okay, so I hope you will understand the solution of that questions. If you want to calculate the angular speed of the gear, see here I'm just showing you how to calculate the what would be the speed of the angular speed of the gear C. However, it is not asking in the question, but I'm showing you that is y is equal to minus 500 minus and x value is given, that is minus, that is 500 multiply TB is given in the question, that is 20 upon TC is 40. Okay, that is 2 and that is 250, and you will get minus 750 rpm. That means 750 rpm anti-clockwise. So here you can see C is also in anti-clockwise direction as well as D is also in anti-clockwise direction, because both are, because D is actually the connected internally with C and these are internal gears. Okay, so that's why whatever be the direction of the C will be the same direction for the gear D. Okay, so this is how you can solve the questions based on the epicyclic gear train arrangement. One question is fixed in the gate examinations or, and the question is of 2 marks, not 1 mark, it is of 2 marks questions. So be prepared for that epicyclic gear train problems. Okay.